this year of 2016, I described my first species of ants.
The Veneta Maya spinus avis. It lives in Madagascar.
Two of them are what we call aelid nudibranchs, and then several species in the genus Felini.
This is Spenfris Gasperini, and is the Trinidad sweeper, or a Gasperini sweeper.
It's a fish that is endemic to a very small island off of Brazil, and it's found only in tide pools of this island. Grammatonotus brienne is a fish that comes from the twilight zone, very deep waters off of the Philippines. We collected it about 490 feet deep. It was the deepest species ever collected by a diver.
You cannot find them easily, you can find everything but them. So that's the nice thing also, because when you are finding them, it's like you are finding a treasure. You want to scream and tell everyone, I found it, and then you are a hero in the field.
We call it like a spiny grandfather because it's so kind of gray and bristly. It's kind of a weird looking fly, but special and new to science.
They have all these little finger-like appendages that are extensions of their digestive tract, and they can store the stinging cells from the sea anemones upon which they feed, then use those for their own defense.
Do I have anything in common with the ants I described?
Huh.
Well, some of them are hairy, and I'm pretty hairy sometimes. Other ants have big teeth. I sometimes have big teeth when I'm eating a barbecue. But other ants love just to be in the dark leaf litter. And actually, when I'm in a rainforest, that's my favorite place.
They are not calm, they are predators. I'm not that calm, and so I think that we have this thing in common.
I imagine for this fly to persist where it is in Madagascar, so far away from all of its other relatives, it has to have some amount of tenacity and resilience. And so I'd like to think that I also have some of those traits.
I love Trinidad Island, and this species loves Trinidad Island much more than me because it lives only there.
I probably have something in common with the deep species, as I like to go deep and to cold water where it lives.
It reflects the fact that there's so much to be learned about life on our planet. There's so much to be discovered, and that's really exciting to me.
They're the product of millions of years of evolution, and we have to preserve them as well.
We are part of the same network.
It was very important for us to try to discover and to assess our biodiversity before it gets lost.
I've devoted my life to making sure that we can actually use and understand and appreciate the world around us before it's too late.
It really is kind of an ugly fly. It's really not a very good looking fly, unfortunately. I hope next year I'm gonna have a really fancy, beautiful fly, but this year's fly is kind of unfortunate in its ugliness.